Perl Compatible Regular Expressions is a regular expression C library inspired by the regular expression capabilities in the Perl programming language, written by Philip Hazel, starting in summer 1997. PCRE's syntax is much more powerful and flexible than either of the POSIX regular expression flavors and many classic regular expression libraries. The name is misleading, because PCRE and Perl each have capabilities not shared by the other. The PCRE library is incorporated into a number of prominent open-source programs, such as the Apache HTTP Server and the PHP and R scripting languages, and can be incorporated in proprietary software too. As of Perl 5.10, PCRE is also available as a replacement for Perl's default regular expression engine through the re-engine PCRE module. The library can be built using Configure and Make, as well as in Unix, Windows and other environments using CMake. Numerous default settings are chosen at build time. In addition to the PCRE library, a POSIX C wrapper, a Google-contributed native C++ wrapper, several test programs, and the utility program PCREGREP are also included in the distribution and are built in tandem with the library. The PCRE library provides matching only. The C++ wrapper, if used, adds multiple match and replacement functionality. Unless the no-recurse PCRE build option is chosen, adequate stack space must be allocated to PCRE by the calling application or operating system. The amount of stack needed varies for each pattern. For example, to complete the tests provided with PCRETEST, 8 MB of stack space would be needed. While PCRE's documentation cautions that the no-recurse build option makes PCRE slower than the alternative, using it avoids entirely the issue of stack overflows. Features: PCRE has developed an extensive and in some ways unique feature set. While it originally aimed at feature equivalence with Perl, over time a number of features have been first implemented in PCRE and only much later added to Perl. During the PCRE 7X and Perl 5.9X phase, the two projects have coordinated development and are to the extent possible feature equivalent. In some cases, PCRE is included in mainline releases features that originated with Perl 5.9X, and in some cases Perl 5.9X has included features that were previously only available in PCRE. PCRE includes the following features: just-in-time compiler support. This optional feature is available in version 8.20 and above if enabled when the PCRE library is built. Large performance benefits are possible when the calling program utilizes the feature with compatible patterns that are executed repeatedly. The just-in-time compiler support was written by Zoltan Herceg and is not addressed in the POSIX or C++ wrappers. Consistent escaping rules: like Perl, PCRE has consistent escaping rules. Any non-alphanumeric character may be escaped to mean its literal value by prefixing a backslash before the character, and vice versa. Any alphanumeric character preceded by a backslash typically gives it a special meaning. In the case where the sequence has not been defined to be special, it will also be treated as a literal. However, this usage is not forward compatible, as new versions of PCRE may give such patterns a special meaning. A good example of this is backslash r, which had no special meaning prior to PCRE 7. In POSIX regular expressions, sometimes backslashes escaped non-alphanumerics and sometimes they introduced a special feature. Extended character classes: single-letter character classes are supported in addition to the longer POSIX names. For example, backslash d matches any digit exactly as digit would in POSIX regular expressions. Minimal matching: a may be placed after any repetition quantifier to indicate that the shortest match should be used. The default is to attempt the longest match first, and backtrack through shorter matches. For example, a b would match ab in abbab, where a b would match the entire string. Unicode character properties: Unicode defines several properties for each character. Patterns in PCRE can match these properties. For example, backslash pps. Backslash ppa would match a string beginning with any opening punctuation, and ending with any close punctuation such as ABC. Since version 8.10, Matching of certain normal metadata characters can be driven by Unicode properties when the compile option PCRE-UCP is set. The option can be set for a pattern by including at the start of pattern. The option alters behavior of the following metadata characters: /b, /b, /d, /d, /s, /s, /w, /w, and some of the POSIX character classes. For example, the set of characters matched by /w is expanded to include letters and accented letters as defined by Unicode properties. Such matching is slower than the normal non-UCP alternative. Note that the UCP option requires the PCRE library to have been built to include UTF-8 and Unicode property support. Support for UTF-16 is included in version 8.30, while support for UTF-32 was added in version 8.32. Multilin matching: and $ can match at the beginning and end of a string only, or at the start and end of each line within the string depending on what options are set. Newline line break options: when PCRE is compiled, a newline default is selected. Which newline line break is in effect affects where PCRE detects line beginnings and $ends, as well as what matches dot option is set. It also affects PCRE's matching procedure. When an unanchored pattern fails to match at the start of a newline sequence, PCRE advances past the entire newline sequence before retrying the match. If the newline option alternative in effect includes CRLF as one of the valid line breaks, it does not skip the /n in a CRLF if the pattern contains specific /r or /n references. Since version 8.10, the metadata character /n always matches any character other than line break characters. It has the same behavior as dot when the total option, also known as S, is not in effect. The newline option can be altered with external options when a pattern is compiled as well as when it is run. Few applications using PCRE provide users with the means to apply this setting via an external option. So, new in version 7.3, the newline option can also be stated at the start of the pattern using one of the following: LF, newline is a line feed character. Corresponding line breaks can be matched with /n. CR, newline is a carriage return. Corresponding line breaks can be matched with /r. CRLF, newline line break is a carriage return followed by a line feed. Corresponding line breaks can be matched with /r /n. Any of the above encountered in the data will trigger newline processing. Corresponding line breaks can be matched with or with /r. See below for configuration and options concerning what matches /r. Any of the above plus special Unicode line breaks. When not in UTF-8 mode, corresponding line breaks can be matched with or /r. In UTF-8 mode, two additional characters are recognized as line breaks with LS and PS. On Windows, in non-Unicode data, some of the any line break characters have other meanings. For example, /x85 can match a horizontal ellipsis, and if encountered while the any new line is in effect, it would trigger new line processing. See below for configuration and options concerning what matches /r. /r options: new in version 7.4, when PCRE is compiled, a default is selected for what matches /r. The default can be either to match the line breaks associated any or those corresponding to any. The default can be overridden when necessary by including or at the start of the pattern. When providing an option, you can also provide an option, for example, any rest of pattern. The /r options also can be changed with external options by the application calling PCRE when a pattern is compiled as well as when it is run. Beginning of pattern options, line break options such as documented above. /r options such as documented above. Unicode character properties option documented above. And option documented as follows: since version 7.9, if your PCRE library has been compiled with UTF-8 support, you can specify the option at the beginning of a pattern instead of setting an external option to invoke UTF-8 mode. Named subpatterns: a subpattern may be named by including a leading P after the open paren. Named subpatterns are a feature that PCRE adopted from Python regular expressions. Since PCRE 7.0, named groups can be defined using or as well as. Named groups can then be invoked with, for example, back references. A pattern may refer back to the results of a previous match. For example, C/1 would match either ACA or BCB, and would not match, for example, ACB. Subroutines, while a back reference provides a mechanism to refer to that part of the subject that has previously matched a subpattern, a subroutine provides a mechanism to reuse an underlying previously defined subpattern. The subpattern's options, such as case independence, are fixed when the subpattern is defined. 1. Would match AACABC or ABCADC, whereas using a back reference /1 would not, though both would match ARC or ABCABC. Starting with version 7.7, PCRE also supports a non-Perl onigramma construct for subroutines. They are specified using /G or /G. Atomic grouping. Atomic grouping is a way of preventing backtracking in a pattern. For example, a BC will match as many AS as possible, and never back up to try one less. Look ahead and look behind assertions. Patterns may assert that previous text or subsequent text contains a pattern without consuming matched text. For example, match is a word followed by a tab, without including the tab. Look behind assertions cannot be of uncertain length. Since version 7.2, /k can be used in a pattern to reset the start of the current whole match. This provides a flexible alternative approach to look behind assertions because the discarded part of the match need not be fixed in length. Escape sequences for zero-width assertions, for example /b for matching zero-width word boundaries, similar to 1. $per will match in Perl but not in PCRE. The value of a capture buffer deriving from the quantifier when nested in another quantified capture buffer is different, ABBA equals. Will result in $1 containing A and $2 containing UNF in Perl, but in PCRE will result in $2 containing B. PCRE allows named capture buffers to be given numeric names. Perl requires the name to follow the rule of bare words. This means that /G is unambiguous in Perl, but potentially ambiguous in PCRE. PCRE does not support certain experimental Perl constructs, such as nor the construct, although the latter can be emulated using recursion control verbs added in the Perl 5.9x series are also not supported. Support for experimental backtracking control verbs is available in PCRE since version 7.3. They are and. Perl's corresponding use of arguments with backtracking control verbs is not generally supported. Note, however, that since version 8.10, PCRE supports the following verbs with a specified argument, and. PCRE and Perl are slightly different in their tolerance of erroneous constructs. Perl allows quantifiers on the construct, which is meaningless but harmless. PCRE produces an error. PCRE has a hard limit on recursion depth. Perl does not, with default build options BBBBXCXAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAA equals will fail to match due to stack overflow, but Perl will match this correctly. Perl uses the heap for recursion and has no hard limit for recursion depth, whereas PCRE has a compile time hard limit. With the exception of the above points, PCRE is capable of passing the tests in the Perl to tests file, one of the main syntax-level regression tests for Perl's regular expression engine. See also, comparison of regular expression engines, list of regular expression software. References. External links. PCRE homepage, user contributions, changelog.